Today I am going to deliver a lecture on probability. Probability theory is, as a matter of fact, is a study of random or unpredictable experiment and is useful in investigating the important feature of these random experiments. The first probability definition given by James Bernoulli, which is mathematical or classical probability. And first time James Bernoulli obtained the quantitative measure of uncertainty. The definition is, if a random experiment or trial is in n exhaustive, mutually exclusive and equally likely outcomes or cases, and m of them are favorable to happening an event E, then probability P of happening of event E is given by ratio of number of favorable cases and total number of cases, which is m by I. But in this definition, there are some limitations where this definition is breakdown. And these cases are, the various outcomes of trials are not equally likely or equally probable. For example, a candidate will pass the test. Probability of a candidate will pass a certain test is 50%, not equally likely, because there are two possibilities. First one is success and second one is failure. Avoiding the condition of a compartment. Second condition, exhaustive number of cases in a trial is infinite or unknown. In that case, classical definition of probability remain fail. And for example, if we select even numbers less than 10 out of natural numbers. So natural number consists number of infinite numbers 1, 2, 3 and so on. And in favorable number of cases is 2, 4, 6, 8, which are less than 10 and even numbers. But the total number of exhaustive cases are infinite, so we cannot find the probability by this definition. Next one, statistical or empirical definition of probability. In which, if n times an event E happens n times, then probability P of happening of event E is given by limiting condition when n tends to infinity of m by n, which means probability of P equal to limit n tends to infinity m by n, number of favorable cases or number of times events happen and number of trials represent n. Limiting case of empirical probability. If an experiment is repeated large number of times, the experimental condition may not remains identical and homogeneous. And second is, the limit may not attain the unique value, however large n. Now the important definition of probability which describes many of the important features of probability. Axiomatic approach to the probability or axiomatic definition of the probability. The axiomatic definition of probability includes both classical and statistical definition as particular cases and overcomes the deficiencies of each of them. On this basis, it is possible to construct a logically perfect structure of the modern theory of probability. This modern theory of probability introduced probability as a simple number associated with each outcomes or events of the experiment or trial. It is based on certain axioms which express the rules for operating with such numbers. So definition is, let S be a sample space of a random experiment. If to each event A of sample space S, we associate a number PA, then PA is called probability of event A. If the following axioms are hold, the first axiom For every event A of the sample space, probability of A always greater than or equal to 0, and this axiom known as axioms of non-negativity. The second axiom is, for a sure event S, probability of sure event is equal to 1, and this axiom is known as axioms of certainty. The third axiom is important. For any finite number or countably infinite number of mutually exclusive events A1, A2, A3 and so on, then probability of happening at least one of them or some of these probabilities is equal to sum of their respective probabilities. And that is, probability of sum is sum of the probabilities. And this axiom known as axioms of additivity. Now we discuss some theorems on probability. In development of probability theory, all the results are derived directly or indirectly by using only axioms of probability, which are mentioned in axiomatic definition of probability. That is, three axioms. First, axioms of non-negativity. Second, axioms of certainty. And third, axioms of additivity. In this section, we shall prove some theorems which help us to evaluate the probability of some complicated events. The first is, probability of impossible event is 0. That is, probability of y equal to 0. We can prove easily by the axiom of probability definition, and we know that sample space and S and impossible event phi are mutually disjoint events. Mutually disjoint means S union phi is equal to S. Now probability of this event given by probability of S union phi equal to probability of S. In left hand side, there are two events, certain event and impossible event, and both are the mutually disjoint events, so that by the third axiom of probability of S union phi equal to probability of S plus probability of phi is equal to probability of S, and this implies that probability of phi is equal to 0, which shows probability of impossible event is 0. Now, next theorem is, probability of complementary event of A, event A. If in a sample space A be any event, then their complementary will be remaining all the events except A. And this part shows the complementary event of any event A. So it is clear in this Venn diagram, event A and their complement are mutually disjoint event, and their union constraint as sample space. So probability of A union A bar or complement of A or not A is equal to probability of sample space. Now probability of A union complement of A, where A and A bar or complement of A is a mutually disjoint or mutually exclusive event. So by third axiom of additivity, left hand side converted into probability of A plus probability of not A or complement of A equal to probability of certain event always 1, and therefore probability of complementary event of event A is equal to 1 minus probability of A. Next is addition rule or addition theorem of the probability. If events are mutually exclusive or mutually destroyed events, then in that case we apply directly third axioms of probability definition, axiomatic definition of probability. And in case when events are not mutually destroyed, we apply this formula, which are if event A and B are two events and are not mutually destroyed, then probability of A or probability of B or probability of at least one of A or B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A and B. In the diagram, it is shown these are two events A and B, and which are not mutually destroyed because there are common part between A and B is A intersection B. So first we convert A union B into mutually disjoint events and then find the probability of A union B by third axioms of the axiomatic probability definition, which are axioms of additivity. So A union B shows only A and not B. This set involves A and B both, and this part of the A union B shows not A and B, which means in this region contain only A not B, in this region contain both A and B, and in this third region contain B only not A. So there are three mutually disjoint events whose union is A union B, which are A and not B, or A and B, or not A and B. So probability of A union B is probability of union of these three events. Now these three events are mutually disjoint events, so by axioms of additivity, probability of these three events at least happening of at least one event is equal to sum of their individual probabilities, which are probability of A and not B plus probability of A and B plus probability of not A and B. Now we find probability of A and not B. So probability of A and not B, A and not B is equal to reason A and not B represented by reason A minus reason A intersection B, and probability of A and not B is equal to probability of A minus probability of A intersection B. Similarly, probability of or a reason which contains only B not A is equal to B minus A intersection B. We subtract A intersection from B, we get not A and B. And probability of not A and B is equal to probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. So we put these values in the given condition, probability of A minus probability of A intersection B in place of probability of A not B plus probability of A intersection B as it is, plus in place of probability of not A and B, we replace probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. And conclusion is probability of A union B equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. there are some current logic related to addition theorem of probability when events are not mutually disjoint. The first corollary, if event A and B are mutually exclusive events, that means there is no common events between them, then their intersection or their happening together conditions is equal to 5. And therefore, probability of A intersection B equal to probability of impossible event is equal to 0. And therefore, probability of A union B equal to probability of A plus probability of B only, because of probability of A intersection B is equal to 0. Corollary second, for three non-mutually exclusive events A, B and C, probability of happening at least one of them is equal to probability of A plus probability of B plus probability of C minus probability of A intersection B minus probability of B intersection C minus probability of C intersection A plus probability of A intersection B intersection C. Here intersection shows both events happening together, A and B, B and C, C and A, and A, B and C all. We can prove easily this theorem with help of diagram or directly by previous definition or theorem. Then A, B and C. So A intersection B and this common part shows B intersection C, and this region shows A and B and C. So we apply the formula of probability of A union B union C equal to probability of A union B union C. Now this event convert into previous theorem and apply the formula directly. So probability of A union B union C equal to probability of A union probability of B union C is equal to probability of A plus probability of B union C minus probability of A intersection B union C. Because of events A, B and C are not mutually exclusive, so their common events exist, and the probability of A union B union C equal to probability of A plus probability of B union C minus probability of A intersection B union C. Now we again apply, if two events are mutually disjoint, then probability of such event. So probability of A as it is, probability of B union C in this case, probability of B plus probability of C minus probability of B intersection C or B and C minus probability of A intersection B union C. Here intersection distribute over union by the definition of set theory. So here probability of A intersection B or probability of or union of probability of A intersection C. So we again apply probability of two mutually disjoint events which are A intersection B and A intersection C. So probability of A as it is plus probability of B same plus probability of C minus probability of B intersection C as it is minus now probability of A intersection B union probability of A intersection C probability of A intersection B plus probability of A intersection C minus probability of A intersection B intersection A intersection C which is equal to probability of A intersection B intersection C and therefore probability of A union B union C equal to probability of A plus probability of B plus probability of C minus probability of B intersection C minus probability of A intersection B minus probability of A intersection C plus probability of A intersection B intersection C. Now we consider an example which is related to mutually exclusive or events. An integer is so chosen at random from 200 digits. What is the probability that integer is divisible by 6 or 8? In the sample space of the experiment consists 1 to 200 numbers and therefore total number of exhaustive cases is equal to 200. Now event integer is divisible by 6 consists sample points let event E show that the chosen number divisible by 6 and event E consists 6, 12, 18 to 198 and therefore number of favorable cases for this event is equal to 198 by 6 which is 33. Now let this one event be E1 and E2 be the event that integer so chosen is divisible by 8. So sample is called of event E to be 8, 12 to 200 and therefore number of favorable cases for event E2 is 200 divided by 8 which is 25. So number divisible by 6, 33 in 200 integers and E2 is the event that number divisible by 8 is 25. Now number divisible by 6 and 8 both and in this case first we find LCM of 6 and 8. So LCM of 6 and 8 is 24 and therefore number divisible by 24 is 24, 48 and 192. Therefore number of favorable cases for event E3, which shows the chosen number or integer is divisible by 6 and 8 both, is equal to 192 divided by 24, which is 8. So total number of adjusted cases in this experiment is 200. Number of favorable cases that the chosen number is divisible by 6 is 33, by divisible by 8 is 25, and divisible by both, which means 6 and 8 both, is 8. So probability of event E1 or E2 is equal to probability of E1 plus probability of E2 minus probability of event E1 and E2 or intersection. So events are not mutually distant in this case, because there are 8 integers which are divisible by both the numbers 6 and 8. So probability of a number or integer divisible by 6, 33 favorable cases out of 200 cases, so probability of even is equal to 33 by 200. Probability of number divisible by 8 is favorable cases 25, in this case total number of exhausted cases 200, minus probability of even and E2. Its probability of a number divisible by 6 and 8 both is 8 out of total 200 numbers, and therefore required probability is 50 by 200 or 1 by 4. So if events are not mutually distant, then such events which are counted 2 times be subject from the total cases, total favorable cases, and we find required probability. Now, multiplication law of probability and conditional probability for event A and B. The probability of happening simultaneously of A and B is equal to a probability, if event A occur first, then probability of A into probability of B when A has been occurred. And if event B occurred first, then probability of B into probability of A when B has been occurred. Where probability of B when A has been occurred, or probability of B by A, represent conditional probability of occurrence of event B when A already happened. And similarly, probability of A by B when is the conditional probability of happening of event A, given that B already happened. That is, probability of simultaneous occurrence of two events A and B is equal to the product of the probability of one of these events and the conditional probability of the other, given that first event has occurred. Now, remark related to conditional probability. Conditional probability of any event B when A has been occurred is given by probability of A intersection B or A and B divided by probability of A, which is given by multiplication law of probability. And probability of event A when B has been occurred is given by probability of A intersection B when and divided by probability of B. Thus, the conditional probabilities B by A and A by B are defined if and only if probability of A is not equal to 0 and probability of B not equal to 0 respectively. The second remark is probability of B when probability of probability of B when event B already occurred. So this event is a certain event which has been already completed, so their probability is 1. And in third case, if probability of A and if event A and B and C are three events in a sample space such that probability of A intersection B not equal to 0, then probability of A intersection B intersection C means probability of happening event A, B and C together is equal to probability of event A occur first into probability of event B when event A has been occurred, and probability of event C when probability of, when event A and B both has been occurred. For example, a person has undertaken a construction job, the probabilities are 0.65 that there will be strike. 0.80 the construction job will be completed on time if there is no strike, and 0.02 that the construction job will be completed on time if there is a strike. Determine the probability that a construction job will be completed on time. So in this question, there are two possibilities in which construction will be completed on time, without strike and with strike. So this question related to conditional probability of the events. So we assume first, let A be the event that construction job will be completed on time, which we want to find. And second, let B be the event that there will be strike. Then their complementary B bar shows there is no strike. To find the probability of event A, which was our question, given part first we find probability of B, means probability of there will be strike is 0.65. Therefore, probability of not strike is 1 minus 0.65, which is equal to 0.35. Now, conditional probability that construction job will be completed on time if there is a strike, means construction job completed on time but there will be a strike. Probability of A when B has been occurred is equal to 0.32, which is given in the question. And second one is the probability, conditional probability, that is the construction job will be completed on time if there is no strike, which is probability of A when B bar has been occurred, or probability that construction job will be completed if there is no strike, is equal to 0.80. So we divide, or there are two possibilities that construction job will be completed on time is construction job A completed with strike, first event A and B, or the second possibility is construction job will be completed with no strike. So A and B bar, if there is no strike and construction job completed, if there is a strike and construction job completed, there are two possibilities, and other only one of out of these two possibility. So these two events are mutually disjoint event. If you draw a diagram where divided into sample space, if there is a strike and if there is no strike, and construction job will be completed any one with these events B or complement of B, then these two events are mutually disjoint events. Here A intersection B or A intersection B bar are mutually disjoint or mutually exclusive when. So by axioms of additivity, probability of A equal to sum of these two events. Probability of sum of these two events, which are probability of A equal to probability of A intersection B plus probability of A intersection complementary of B. So by conditional probability rule, probability of A intersection B equal to event B occur first, so probability of B into probability of A when B has been occurred plus probability of complementary of event B into probability of A when event complementary of event B has been occurred. So probability of B given in this question part 0.65, probability of conditional probability of A when B has been occurred 0.32, probability of B bar is given by 0.35, and conditional probability of A when B bar has been occurred is 0.08, and since after simplification we get 0.49%, 0.49 probability that construction job will be completed on time with or without step cases. Now, independent events. The previous section defined the dependency or related to a dependent events. In this case, we define independent events. Two or more events said to be independent if happening or non-happening of any of them does not in any way affect the happening of the other events. And the mathematical definition, an event is said to be independent or statistically independent of another event B, that is probability or conditional probability of A when B has been occurred is equal to unconditional probability of B, that is conditional probability of A when B has been occurred is equal to probability of A. There is a correction. Similarly, if event B said to be independent to event A, that is probability, then conditional probability of B when A has been occurred is equal to unconditional probability of B. So events are independent, then their happening and non-happening does not affect the happening of remaining events. Multiplication theorem of probability for independent events. If event A and B are two events with positive probabilities, positive probability means probability is not equal to zero, more than zero, and probability of B is not equal to zero, then A and B are independent if and only if probability of happening together of the events A and B is equal to probability of A into probability of B. And we can show probability of A intersection B equal to probability of A into probability of B easily by the definition of conditional probability. So the probability of A intersection B is given by probability of A. If A occurred first, then probability of B when A has been occurred if events are not independent. But by the definition of independent event, conditional probability of event B is equal to unconditional probability of event B. When events are independent, then probability of A into probability of similarly, if event B occur first, then the conditional probability is the probability of B when and probability of A when B has been occurred. If events are independent, then their conditional probability is equal to their unconditional probability, and therefore probability of A and B equal to probability of A into probability of B. We can extend this theorem for n independent events, and in that case, necessary and sufficient condition of independence of n event A1, A2, A3, to An is that the probability of simultaneous happening is equal to the product of their respective probabilities. That means probability of A1 intersection A2 intersection A3 to intersection An is equal to probability of A1 into probability of A2 into probability of A3 to probability of An. The next example is, the odds that a person X speak truth are 3:2, and the odds that a person Y speak truth are 5:3. In both percentage of cases, they are likely to contradict each other on identical points. Odds mean number of favorable cases. Odds in favor means odds that speak truth. In this case, odds that a person X speak truth is number of favorable cases to speak truth and number of non-favorable cases to speak truth. So first we assume that A be the event that X speak truth and B be the event that Y speak truth. Then and their complementary events A bar and B bar represent X and Y speak lie respectively. So probability of event A, that is X speak truth, the odds in favor of speak truth is 3:2, therefore probability of A is equal to 3 divided by P+2, and probability of A bar that A speak, X speak lie is equal to 2 divided by 3+2, which is 3 by 5 and 2 by 5. And similarly, probability of Y speak truth is R in ratio 5:3, therefore 5 by 5 plus 3 equal to 5 by 8. And probability of Y speak lie B bar is equal to 3 by 8. Now, in the question, in what percentage of the cases they are likely to contradict each other on an identical point? And there are possible cases for this condition. First one, A speak truth and B speak lie. And for second condition, A speak lie and B speak truth. So let A be the event which that they will be contradict each other on an identical point, and the possible events for this event are X speak truth and Y speak lie. First possibility, or A speak lie and B speak truth. So there are only two possibilities in which they are likely to contradict each other on an identical point. And these two events, A and B bar and A bar and B, are mutually disjoint events. And so by the probability of E is equal to probability of A and B bar union A bar and B. Events are mutually disjoint or mutually exclusive, so probability of their union is equal to probability of A intersection B bar plus probability of A bar intersection B. Now, that person X and Y state their statement independently. So, probability of A intersection B bar is equal to probability of A into probability of B bar. Multiplication of their individual probability plus similarly for second event probability of A bar into probability of B. Probability of A bar and B. For A bar and B occur simultaneously, then their probability is multiplication of their individual probabilities. Now we put probability of A 3 by 5 into probability of B bar, B is B fly, 3 by 8 plus probability of A bar, A is B fly, 2 by 5 and probability of B that Y is B truth, 5 by 8. So 49 plus 10. So 19 by 40 probability that they will contradict each other on the identical point and their percentage, which means multiply by 100 and we get the percentage. So 19 by 40 into 100 is equal to their respective percentage, in which they will contradict each other on the identical points. So in this question, the important part is event E, which shows that they will be contradict each other on identical point, and B, find the possibilities of happening of these events. So A bar and B and A and B bar, which shows A speak like and B speak, A speak truth and B speak like, which shows the condition of contradiction. And in second case, X speak lie and Y speak truth, which shows the contradiction of or their conditions or their statements. And these two events are mutually destroyed. So when exempts of additivity, sum of the probability of these two events are independent. They state their statement independently, so multiplication of their individual probability and then substitute the value, we get the required result. Given n independent events ai, where I vary from 1 to n, which means a1, a2, a3 to an, with the respective probabilities of occurrence of a1, probability of a1, probability of a2, probability of an, then find the probability of occurrence at least one of them. For this statement, first we define or show the De Morgan's law, which are complementary of union is equal to intersection of their complementary. Hence, the probability of happening at least one of the event is given by probability of A1 union A2 union and so on union AN is equal to 1 minus probability of not happening of the events at least one of the A1 to AN. Now, by De Morgan's law, 1 as it is minus probability of intersection of their complements, A1 bar intersection A2 bar intersection and so on intersection of AN, equal to 1 minus probability of, and these events are independent events, therefore probability of happening at least one of them is equal to 1 minus probability of A1 into probability of A2 into probability of and so on to AN. So probability of happening at least one of the event A1, A3, A2, AN is equal to 1 minus probability of none of the events A1, A2, A3 to N happens. Or equivalently, probability of non-happening of the events is equal to 1 minus probability of at least one of the events can happen. That's all for today. For the next part, we consider in the next lecture. Thank you.